So here we are in After Effects, and let's go ahead and get started. We're going to create this 1920 by 1080, and this will just be 5 seconds. We go down here, and I'm going to get this newspaper clipping that I found, okay? And before I start, though, I will go ahead and tell you that I went to FreePick. There's no reason to go out and try to create all your own assets when they have this free stuff here. And I just kind of went over here and picked up this and see, all you have to do is download it. Notice that there is attribution required here. So if you use it for like a YouTube video or something like that, just make sure you give credit where credit is due, because some creative went in here and put this whole thing together. And I can't imagine having to create something like that on my own. So I went ahead and downloaded that, and you see that it's very small compared to what we have here. So let's really scale this thing up and move it. And notice we're on full resolution, and this thing is looking pretty hideous right now, isn't it? And that's because we need to go over here and notice this. It says collapse transformation or continuously rasterize, in our case of a vector. And give it a second, boom, there it goes. First thing we need to do is create a path, okay? So I've hit the letter G, and I'm going to click here, click here, click here, click here, and then kind of click here. I don't want to close this thing up because we are creating kind of that scribbly, circly type thing. Now we go down here to convert vertex tool, and we are going to just kind of smooth out this circle and make something of it. More like an oval, probably, actually. And this isn't a big lesson on the usage of the pin tool. Okay, let's just say for our purposes, that's what we want to make. We hit the letter M. Go over here to this mask path that we just created. Go down, make sure you're in that mask path, and you hit Command or Control C to copy that. Now, turn the eyeball off, so we can turn that layer off because we don't need it right now. Create a new solid called, and I'm just going to call it circle. If you double click on this, you're going to go from the composition, and now you're inside the layer. That's the only way you're going to get this brush tool to do what you want it to do. And here's the different brushes we have accessible to us, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. I'm just going to click one time, and when I did that, it went ahead and applied the paint tool. We can hit E here and go down, and there's that brush stroke that we just created right over here somewhere. But we've already copied this path for that circle. I'm gonna hit Command V or Control V to paste it in. The reason why I did it this way was because trying to draw it on with a mouse, you could probably do pretty decent with a Wacom tablet, but with a mouse, there's just no way that's gonna happen. So this is what we have. Now you're going, okay, can we kind of get something to emulate that would look a little bit more like a real circle? Hardness is 100%. Yeah, we want the hardness up. We don't want this feathered or anything like that. And let's go a little bit down with this roundness. Okay, and it's going to make it more of an oval. Definitely push it way towards the oval. And then if we play with the angling here, now the angling is really going to do something. And that way, it's going to match the contours of drawing a scribbling on a circle. We might want to take that diameter down a little bit now because we don't want that thick a marker. Just depending on what you want. I can hit V. And now, how do we animate this? Because you go off here, and if you've never used the brush tool, you'll know that whatever you've drawn on only lasts for one frame, okay? So if we hit function, shift, in the right arrow. Let's go all the way down to the end of our comp here because we don't know how long we want this to be. And you're going to see for our brush one that we have created that it's only lasting one frame. So we need to drag that all the way out. And now we kind of have something we can work with. And then let's go to the 1 second mark. There's 100%. And we go back down to 0% with that keyframe. and then we select both of those. We do a function F9 maybe, and hit the graph editor tool like I always do, and just to get it. And usually you start off slow and then you kind of round the corners, and yeah, something like that. Kind of, we don't want it to be too slow because nobody draws really slow, you know. And that looks good to me. So here we are. Now we just gotta line this thing up, right? And we can even kind of just get in here and sort of eyeball this. If you want to, let's say we want to highlight this free concert. And I'm gonna go back over here and increase the amount of this diameter just a little bit more. And that's really all there is to it, you know? You might want to go in here and go a little bit, dial a little bit back on the opacity, because a marker does tend to bleed through the text, and that's a little bit too much bleeding, but as you know, you can go down in the 80s there. Can even, if you want to go, hit one of these blending modes, but I'm not going to do that today. If you don't like the color of this, easy thing to do is just go over here to generate fill. And let's say you go, I want to do a highlighter after it's all said and done. You know, one of those dark green kind of highlighter things. And you can do that. And that's really one of many ways you can draw out one of these scribbly circle things. But if you're just in a pinch and you just want to do this without doing a bunch of masking and a whole bunch of other things, you can always do it this way with the brush tool. Okay.